Hi there, weavers. Welcome back. This is Grace with Tangled Webs Weaving, and I am starting towel number 2 on our Strickler 8 sampler towels. So as a reminder, this is a white 8-2 warp that I have warped up in a straight draw, and I am trying several different patterns based out of the Carol Strickler book. This is number 2. You can go back and look at the first towel that I wove, which I call Zebra Stripes. This one is called Optical Illusions, and hopefully the towel will turn out as cool looking as the drawdown looked on the computer. So we'll see though. So let's get started weaving. All right, so you can see I have the previous towel on the loom, and we're starting the second one, and I'm going to start with this color. We're going to use the same four blues as we did in this one, but we're not going to graduate them. There's going to be specific stopping points on each pattern. So the first thing I'm going to do is throw a couple picks of just an 8-4 cotton to divide my towels. And now you'll notice that I did not cut this weft thread when I finished this towel, because I knew I was going to use the same weft color, and I will just continue weaving on and it will get cut, but it gets woven in, or it gets in with the hem. So we'll just do our hem allowance again. Okay, so I've got about 2/3 of my hem done, and so I'm going to throw a double pick, and that will be the line that I fold to. It's similar to putting in a pick of waste yarn that I can pull out later, but I won't pull this out. I'll just fold on this line. So I'll weave the rest of my hem. So there is my hem allowance, and now we will start in on the pattern. So in weaving this, it is a very simple weave. So the treadling is one through, it's kind of like an M's and W's. So we'll just start in, and this one, I believe, is going to be very similar to the last one, where we're going to have to be careful of how hard we beat. So now we're going to switch into what is hopefully going to create the optical illusion of making these chevrons look like they're getting narrower when they really aren't. So hopefully the weaving part of it looks as cool as it did on the screen.
I'm on my own, broken and alone. I feel the rain crashing down all around this empty town. I'm searching for the lost and found. But you don't care, you're unaware. Keep moving like the scars aren't even there. It's in the air, like a blazing flare.
So there we have our rug number two. I think it turned out really good. I think that the set is definitely an issue. We've got a long floats here, and I'm not sure that this is going to make great dish towel material, but it might make good pillowcase covers or something like that. We'll see what it looks like after it's wet finished. I do want to experiment with a different set on this using maybe a 24 ends per inch. I think that that would actually work a lot better. But that's why we're doing this project, to experiment and see what works and what doesn't. That is the downfall with the 8-shaft pattern book by Strickler, is that it doesn't tell you what yarns to use. It just gives you patterns to use and play with. So that's why you sample. I hope you've enjoyed watching me make this towel. I certainly have learned a lot while weaving it. If you did like the video, please give it a thumbs up and consider subscribing to my channel if you haven't already. Thanks for watching and happy weaving, and stay tuned for number 3.